Let me show you the recipe.
Recipe.
For a preacher.
That's right.
Listen at the word of God here.
Paul, a servant of God.
Paul, a servant of God.
And an apostle of Jesus
Christ.
What
is an apostle? One that God called, God sent, God made, God appointed. God taught, God authorized, God revealed himself. Some folks say there ain't no apostles now. Stop lying. Well, Paul said he was the last apostle. He did not.
No.
Paul ain't never say he was the last one.
No.
Paul said he was the least
of the apostles.
Mm-hmm. The least. He didn't say he was the last.
No.
Like in another place, Paul said he's the least of all saints.
Right.
He ain't the last saint that was living.
No.
If so, we wouldn't be here.
That's right.
I want to say to all viewers, you should not be paying T.D. Jakes. Mm-hmm. You should not be paying Creflo Dollar.
Yeah.
You should not be paying Fred Price. Yeah. You should not be paying none of these fellas.
Yeah.
Just to preach.
Just to preach.
The word of God is free.
That's right.
Amen. I come to your church and wire it up with the scripture. Thank God and level your entire church right down. I smash it down.
That's right.
With the Bible. That's and you ain't got to give me nothing.
This letter is from, it says, regarding 1 Corinthians chapter 10, if there are divisions in the church and no other church in your area believes that things you believe, what should I do? This person asks.
What should you do? Let's see what Micaiah told him to do.
Mm-hmm.
Let's see what Micaiah advised everybody to do.
That's right.
Give me the book of Kings.
Kings.
If there's not a church in your area that's standing for the truth, I want to tell you what the Bible advised everybody to do.
In 1 Kings chapter 22 and at verse 17.
Follow me.
And he said, I saw all Israel,
scattered upon the hills,
as sheep that have not a shepherd.
That's the problem. The churches don't have no shepherd.
That's right.
They don't have no leader.
That's right.
They don't have no watchman.
Amen.
They just got junk in the pulpit.
Amen.
The devil recycled something.
That's right.
And threw it in the pulpit.
Amen. That's right.
All right.
And the Lord said.
Who said it?
The Lord said.
No, Jennings said it.
The Lord said.
What did the Lord say that they should do?
Wait.
What did the Lord say they should do if they don't have no shepherd?
Let them return every man to his house in peace.
Go home.
Yeah, that's right.
Amen.
Go home.
Go home. Let them return.
Go home.
That's right.
The Bible says, let's read all of that again.
And he said, I saw all Israel,
scattered upon the hills
as sheep that have not a shepherd.
The sheep is the church. The shepherd is supposed to be those that lead.
That's right.
And when the people are scattered like a sheep that have no shepherd, they have no one to teach them, no one to guide them, no one to warn them, no one to discipline them, no one to turn them to God, nobody to open up their understanding.
And the Lord
said, when you're in that condition and you don't have a church,
let them return.
The Lord said,
let them return.
Let them return
every man,
everyone,
to his house in peace.
Go home.
That's right.
Wonderful.
That's right.
Amen.
Go home.
Hallelujah to God.
Go home.
Go home.
That's right.
Bible didn't tell you take it upon yourself to have a Bible class.
No.
You men that are watching me now, I get letters from so many of you, I can't count.
Amen.
You don't have the authority to just get some people together.
No.
And take it upon yourself to teach the scriptures.
No, no.
Some of you men jump up in the pulpit and say, you know why? A lot of these churches have jumped up because some brother in a church disagreed with some preacher.
Yeah.
And notice, he ain't got no calling until he disagree.
That's right.
Am I right, man?
Amen.
Notice, he ain't got no calling. He ain't got no anointing. But the moment he disagree, he opened up his mini market.
That's right.
That's right.
Right then, jump in the pulpit.
Amen.
You gotta be qualified. Give me the first chapter of the book of Titus.
First chapter of Titus.
All you men out here that claim you elders.
Yeah.
Let me educate you. God, do not call and send elders direct. He make it plain in the Bible.
That's right.
Those who he call and send direct.
That's right.
Give me Luke 11:49. Wonderful. Stay ahead of me, son. Wonderful. I don't like leaving you.
Luke chapter
11.
But
if I have to, I will, you know.
Luke chapter 11 and verse 49.
What did it say?
Therefore also said the wisdom of God.
Oh, he just want everything to follow him. I want everything to follow God. Oh,
that's it.
This is order, church order.
That's right.
Listen at this.
Luke 11 and verse 49.
What was Jesus teaching?
Therefore also said the wisdom of God.
Anything else is stupid, ignorant, it's foolish, it don't make sense. There's no logic to it.
That's right.
Therefore said the wisdom of God.
I will send them.
God is talking. God is talking.
I will
God
send them.
God is talking. I believe God's testimony.
That's right.
He ought to know what he wants.
That's right.
He ought to know what he should have.
That's right.
I will send them.
I will send them prophets.
Prophets.
And apostles.
And apostles.
And
that lets you know that come direct from God.
That's right. That's right.
Direct from God.
That's right.
All right. Now, there's a whole lot of men, I mean a whole lot, in America and Europe and all that stuff, saying they are elders, and a bishop is an elder. That's another thing y'all got messed up. You're in these churches that you are elder, and then your overseer ordained you a bishop, and you thought you got a promotion.
Right.
That's right.
Same thing.
It's the same thing.
That's right.
The exact same thing.
That's right.
Here you ordained the elder, and then the convention come around, and your demon lay hands on you, and you go from Elder Jones to Bishop Jones. You ain't got no promotion.
No.
You've been conned.
That's right.
You've been bamboozled.
Amen.
You've been duped.
Oh, yeah.
Right in church. Right in church. Amen.
Same office.
If I drive a 2015 Cadillac, that's black. And then you say, Pastor, I want to buy you a new car. And you bring me a 2015 Cadillac that's white. That's identical. The same model and everything.
That's right.
All you did was gave me the same car.
That's right.
Different color.
Just a different color.
That's it.
Huh? The same thing. I'm still Cadillacing.
That's right.
That's right.
I'm still Cadillacing.
Amen.
All right, I want to soak you, because there's a lot of men now that hate this preaching. They're going around teaching, and this was taught before I was born, that you don't have to be ordained. A lot of you is out here in the pulpit because you had a dream, you ate too many beans, you ate too much rice, you got too much starch in your gut, your meat wasn't well done, the blood from the meat that you ate, the mess with your brain.
Amen.
That's
right.
That's it, Pop. That's it. Go ahead.
That's right.
Let me show you the recipe.
The recipe.
For a preacher.
That's right. Titus chapter 1.
Follow me.
And we'll start at verse 1. Paul, a servant of God and an apostle of Jesus Christ.
They upset with me. Like they was upset with Bishop Johnson. Before Bishop Johnson died, the elders around the country were saying, the Bible said ordained elders in every city. You ain't going around every city and ordaining. It ain't a man of God living just going to jump up and start laying hands on folk like a fool.
Like a fool.
Not if you know the Bible.
That's right.
You got qualifications. You got to meet first.
Amen. That's right.
Amen.
You got qualifications first.
First.
So I get letters now. Our Bible said ordained elders in every city. I know it said that. But you got to be qualified first.
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 I ain't going to lay hands on you because you got a good testimony.
No.
I ain't going to lay hands on you because you faithful in coming to church.
No.
I ain't going to lay hands on you because you got keys to the church.
No.
I ain't going to lay hands on you because you're related to me. No. I don't
Go ahead,
care
man.
Nothing about that.
Go ahead.
The only thing that interests me is qualification.
Amen. That's it.
Amen.
That's it.
God's order. Wonderful.
It's God's order.
Yes, that's it.
Listen at the word of God here.
Paul, a servant of God.
Paul, a servant of God.
And an apostle of Jesus Christ.
What is an apostle? One that God called, God sent, God made, God appointed, God taught, God authorized, God revealed himself. Some folks say there ain't no apostles now. Stop lying.
Stop lying.
Well, Paul said he was the last apostle. He did not.
No.
Paul ain't never say he was the last one.
No.
Paul said he was the least
of the apostles.
The least. He didn't say he was the last.
No.
Like in another place, Paul said he's the least of all saints.
All saints.
He ain't the last saint that was living.
No.
If so, we wouldn't be here.
That's right.
Amen.
Are you listening to what I'm telling you?
That's right.
I had someone write me and said, well, the reason why I know there are no apostles now, because all the apostles witnessed the resurrection. That's a lie.
That's a lie.
That's a lie. The apostle Paul wasn't nowhere around when Jesus rose.
No.
Huh?
No.
Paul wasn't here.
No.
Glory to God. Glory to God. He came later.
That's right.
And after Paul came, being a Hebrew of the Hebrews, thank God, God revealed himself.
That's
he said, he revealed his son in me, that I may preach him, thank God, among the heathen.
Among the heathen.
He preach them among the heathen like Peter did.
That's right.
Come on, son.
Paul, a servant of God.
Paul, servant of God.
And an apostle of Jesus Christ.
And an apostle, hallelujah to God, of Jesus Christ.
According to the faith of God's elect.
You know why they don't want no apostles now? Because the apostle is the highest ranking officer in the church.
That's right.
And he laid down rule. And every bishop, every prophet, every elder, every minister, every deacon got to submit themselves to the apostles.
That's right. That's right.
You can't say you believe in the apostles' doctrine and don't believe there's no apostles.
Amen.
It's impossible.
God had set some in the church.
Do you hear what the word of God said?
In 1 Corinthians 12 and verse 28.
This is the doctrine of the apostles here.
And God had set some.
Who did it?
God.
Someone said, I haven't met none. That's your business. That don't mean there ain't none here.
That's right.
What did God say?
God had set some in the church.
God did it?
God. God had set some.
He did what?
God had set some in the church.
What?
First.
If God set them there, the church is still here.
Still here.
And they take everything back then.
That's right.
And they take it now.
That's right.
To perfect the church.
That's right.
Let's read that, then we get the book of Ephesians.
God,
where you are.
God had set some in the church.
What?
First apostles.
Secondarily prophets.
Thirdly teachers.
Let's get the book of Ephesians, son. I want to show you why all this stuff is put in the church.
Now,
Ephesians 4:11.
Now in Ephesians chapter 4 and verse 11.
Listen.
And he gave some apostles.
You see?
Some.
That was set first, right, was made apostles.
And some. Prophets.
You can't have a board of bishops come together and elect you to be some apostle.
No.
Not that.
No.
A bunch of fellas dressed up in Catholic clothes.
That's right.
Little bean. You know, a lot of these apostolic faith now is wearing Catholic garments.
Yeah.
Little bean hats and Catholic clothes and talking about they are apostles. No, you're not.
No, you're not.
You'll put a difference between holy and unholy.
That's right.
Clean and unclean.
That's right.
Come on.
And he gave some apostles.
Some apostles.
And some prophets.
Some prophets.
And some evangelists.
Be quick.
And some pastors and teachers.
What else?
Four.
Get the chapter and verse again.
Now in Ephesians chapter 4, verses 11 and 12.
He gave all these offices for what reason?
For the perfecting of the saints.
No, he moved one of the offices out.
And he gave some apostles and some prophets and some evangelists and some pastors and teachers. For the perfecting of the saints.
If you don't believe in one office, you can never be perfected.
That's right.
If there's one office you don't believe in, you can never get into the kingdom.
For the perfecting of the saints.
The church can never be perfected. If I say one of these offices
don't exist,
you can never go on with God.
That's right.
Never. Because God put them in the church for a reason.
For the perfecting of the saints.
These offices are in the church for all of us.
That's right. For the perfecting of the saints.
You can never be perfected without these offices.
That's right.
God put them in there.
That's right.
No man can take them out.
Right. No.
God put them in.
Amen.
Wonderful.
And he gave some apostles.
Wonderful.
And some prophets.
Some prophets.
And some evangelists. And some pastors.
Pastors.
And teachers.
Teachers.
For the perfecting of the saints.
He put all this in the church so the church can be complete.
For the work.
For what?
For the work of the ministry.
Yes, sir.
Amen.
As for the work of what?
For the work of the ministry.
A bunch of ministers and no apostle?
Amen.
It ain't no apostles now? Well, how did you become an elder?
That's right.
How did you become a bishop?
That's right.
How did you become an evangelist?
Mm-hmm.
You better not tell me God made you an evangelist. I make you lick it up.
Lick that up.
The apostle Paul told Timothy, do
the work of an evangelist.
The work of an evangelist.
That's right.
Philip the evangelist was ordained by the apostles.
Yes, sir.
He laid hands on them. He was one of the seven.
Wonderful.
Go ahead.
I want you to get this good, you little hand-me-down Raggedy Ann and Andy elders.
And he gave some apostles.
Let's get this first chapter of the book of Titus.
Back in Titus chapter 1, now at verse 2.
All right.
In hope of eternal life, which God that cannot lie promised before the world began.
What is it?
And hath in due times manifested his word through preaching.
That's how God is getting his word over.
Through preaching.
And God ain't worrying about because you got dreams and all that stuff. Hey, paying that no mind. Everybody have dreams.
Right.
Dreams don't make you.
No.
No, sir.
No.
Listen.
But hath in due times manifested his word through preaching, which is committed unto me.
Be quick.
According to the commandment of God our Savior.
What?
To Titus, mine own son, after the common faith.
The Apostle Paul's talking to a bishop.
Mm-hmm.
Talking to an elder.
That's right.
That's it. That's it, sir.
To Titus.
My own son. After the common faith.
What is it?
Grace, mercy, and peace.
From God the Father.
And the Lord Jesus Christ our Savior.
What is it?
For this cause.
All right. Here you have the apostles laying instructions to an elder.
That's right.
He laying groundwork to him.
That's right.
For this cause.
Left I thee in Crete.
No, God left you there.
Left I thee in Crete.
Now, the apostle had the authority to tell you where to go. Mm-hmm. When to go, mm-hmm. how long to stay there, yeah. and what to do while you're there.
That's right. That's right.
That's the job of the apostle.
That's right.
Tell you what to do, where to go, what to do while you're there, how long to stay there.
Amen.
That's his job.
Amen.
That's
his job.
Huh?
That's his job.
He got the oversight.
That's right.
Come on, son.
For this cause left I thee in Crete.
There's the Apostle Paul telling Titus, I left you in Crete.
That thou shouldest set in order the things that are wanted.
And I don't want you to let people do what they want to do. So mm-hmm. while you in Crete, I want you to put order. You got to keep order. And when you keep order, you're going to keep order according to what I'm preaching.
That's right.
The order that you keep can't deviate from what you learn.
That's right.
If I teach there's one God, you better keep that order there.
Order.
If I teach the baptism in the name of Jesus Christ, you better keep that order there.
That's right.
If I teach speaking in tongues, the evidence of the Holy Ghost, you better keep that order there.
That's right.
All the order of God must be handed down from one office to the other.
Wonderful.
And nobody's allowed to deviate.
That's wonderful.
That's God's order, sir. Wonderful, sir.
It's
God's order.
That's right.
What did he say?
That thou shouldest set in order.
There's order in the church.
Amen.
He said in order.
The things that are wanting.
Let all things be done decently and in order. And when the minister comes and do something that's out the word of God and disobey order, then the next thing is to be corrected.
That's it.
Discipline.
That's right.
And he got to submit to it.
Yes, sir.
That's right.
Come on.
That thou shouldest set in order the things that are wanting.
And
ordain
now
elders.
Now here's the apostle telling a bishop
mm-hmm.
what to do.
What to do.
I want you to ordain
elders. In every city.
Now listen to that. He's telling him this is the office I want you to get.
Mm-hmm.
I had one man read this. He said, well, Paul was teaching Titus to ordain old men. So only an old man can be an elder. You fool.
That's a fool.
You're so foolish.
That's right.
You're so sad.
Amen.
And these men are up in the pulpit.
Mm-hmm.
Only old men are elders.
Mm.
There's two types of elders.
Yeah.
There's an elder as age, mm-hmm. but he wasn't talking about age here.
No.
He's talking about an office of ministry.
That's right.
This is a work of ministry here.
Work of the ministry.
That's why you got to be careful. You can, even though a brother may be your senior or your elder, you can't walk around freely and call him elder.
No.
You got to use good judgment.
Absolutely.
Because somebody may think that's an office he holds as a preacher.
That's right.
That's
right.
Huh?
That's right.
That's why the brother got to make the correction, even though he may be an elder in age.
I
may not be freely just say, oh, elder so-and-so. Somebody may say, oh, I know he was a preacher.
That's it.
And if the brother don't correct it,
yeah.
and just let a bunch of people keep calling him elder, and yet he's not a preacher,
right.
and don't put the people in check. Well, look, I'm not an elder as preacher. I'm an elder in age.
That's it.
Then be honest and tell him that.
That's right.
For somebody to think you got ordained something that you're not.
That's right.
Mm-hmm.
All right. And ordain elders
ordain
in every city.
Ordain elders in every city as
I.
Who?
I.
As I did what?
Had appointed
them. This man ain't jump out, just start ordaining folk.
No.
You had an apostle to lay hands on them and ordain them.
That's right.
All right, now let's get this.
If any be blameless. If.
The moment it says if, it lets you know we got problems.
That's right.
There's a big if there.
That's right.
If any
be blameless.
If he's overzealous, you can't ordain him.
No.
You can't ordain him.
No.
No. He love money, you can't ordain him.
Can't ordain him.
He don't believe in no apostles now, don't ordain him.
That's right.
He believe you can divorce and remarry, don't you ordain him.
Don't ordain him.
No, don't even bring your hands near him.
Amen.
Kryptonite.
That's right.
Don't touch him.
That's right.
He got a girlfriend? Nope, can't ordain him.
Can't ordain him either.
He's a homosexual? Nope.
No way.
Nope.
No.
Don't ordain him.
Mm-hmm.
He's racist. Don't ordain him.
Don't ordain him.
Mm-mm.
Amen.
He got respected person. Can't ordain you.
Can't ordain him.
Can't even touch it.
No.
Favoritism. No, can't ordain you.
Oh, no.
No. You sneaking, drinking wine. Can't ordain you.
Amen.
Because the Bible said about the bishop not given to wine.
Not given to wine.
Huh?
That's right.
All right.
If any be blameless.
Be blameless.
The husband of one wife.
That don't mean you got to be married to be a preacher. No. That means if you are married, how many wives you got to have?
One wife.
So, no adultery, no divorce, no girlfriend on the hip where you can slip and dip.
That's right. That's right.
That's right.
He's out here making babies. And you can't ordain him.
Can't ordain him.
You can't ordain him.
No.
Are you listening to what I'm telling you?
Amen.
That's why the preachers are upset with this. Pastor Jennings don't ordain a lot of men. That's right.
That's right.
Take my time. I'm not in a hurry.
No.
In fact, a brother who understands teaching, he's not in a hurry.
No way. No way.
He ain't in a hurry.
No way.
You fellas that are watching and listening, see, you love the title.
Amen.
Amen. That's why you run to false prophets and they tell you, well, you can preach, go ahead. You ain't got to wait for nobody to lay hands on you. Just go ahead. I did it.
That's right. That's right.
That's right.
Glory to God. Come on, son.
And ordain elders in every city as I had appointed.
What's the qualification?
If any be blameless.
Blameless.
The husband of one wife.
If you marry only one wife.
Having faithful children.
If your children, now you're responsible for all of them that's under your roof.
Mm-hmm.
They got to be faithful.
Mm-hmm.
Not accused of riot.
Or unruly.
Amen. Long as they're under your roof, you got to follow orders. If your children don't want to follow orders, get out and get your own roof.
That's right.
Just
that's
that simple.
That's it.
Amen. That's just simple.
Amen.
You not living with your parents, you don't want to do what your parents say do, split.
That's right. Huh? Amen.
Bamboos.
Amen.
Bon voyage. Get out.
Get out.
Be gone.
That's right. Amen.
That's just common sense. All right.
For a bishop must be blameless.
There's no maybe so about it.
Must be blameless.
You stealing church money, can't ordain you.
No.
You sneaking playing the lottery, can't ordain you.
No way.
Ain't ordaining you. You playing the lottery? you up there in the pool hall? Ain't ordaining you.
Go ahead, man.
You somewhere shooting crap?
No.
Ain't ordaining you.
No.
You can't take correction? Ain't ordaining you.
Can't ordain. That's right.
You say one thing when your leader's there, and another thing when he's not.
That's right.
You know, ain't ordaining you.
Ain't ordaining you.
That's a double-tongued person.
That's right.
Come on.
For a bishop must be blameless.
What else?
As the steward of God.
He got to be the steward of God.
Not self-willed.
When you're not self-willed, that means you've got discipline.
That's right.
You're going to ordain a self-willed man, a man that won't hear, won't take instructions, won't follow leadership. And this is why you got so many churches. These men, the moment they disagree with some bishop, you know what they say after that? God called me. I tried to avoid the calling.
That's what they say.
I tried to avoid the calling, and I couldn't avoid it no more.
Amen. That's what they say.
I've been running from it for a long time.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And they used the excuse of a disagreement they got with the preacher of starting some church like a little gas station.
Yeah. That's what they do.
That's what they do.
That's what they do.
I smash it into hell.
Amen.
Moment got a disagreement. Oh, God dealing with me. God dealing with me. I got dreams. I have a dream.
That's right.
I wouldn't care if you dreamed that Barney was reading for you. And Big Bird was your choir director.
That's right.
Ernie and Bert was your deacons.
Amen. Amen.
Qualifications you got to have here.
For a bishop must be blameless.
Any man that was not ordained by an apostle and declare yourself to be an elder. And if any man that is a bishop and was ordained by a bishop, and the bishop that ordained you did not get permission from an apostle, like Titus got his from Paul, you did not get the office scripturally.
That's right.
And if you come any other way, what did the Bible call you?
Thief and a robber. Amen.
You preachers that are watching and listening around the world, many of you have not been ordained by an apostle, or you were not ordained by a bishop who got permission from an apostle.
Yeah.
You're relying on Apollos. Mm-hmm. Well, who ordained Apollos? The Bible never said he was an elder.
It never said that.
Huh?
No.
If he was an elder, he was a mighty poor elder.
That's right.
Only knowing the baptism of John.
That's right.
How you going to be an elder only knowing John baptism?
Amen.
Why would you need a husband and a wife to expound on you the more perfect way?
That's right.
The elder's supposed to be teaching the husband and the wife.
That's right.
You shouldn't need Priscilla and Aquila to open up your eyes, and you're an elder.
Amen.
Bible ain't never said Apollos was an elder.
No, never said that.
I heard that lie since I was a little baby.
Mm-hmm.
It's been preached for years.
Amen.
Come on, son.
For a bishop must be blameless.
You fellas, you can duck and dodge all you want. The apostleship hang over your head
hangs over.
A thundercloud.
That's right.
Glory to God.
That's right.
Like a thundercloud.
Amen.
Never get away.
Oh, no.
You never get away from
it.
Come on, son.
For a bishop must be blameless.
A bishop must be blameless.
As the steward of God.
As the steward of God.
Not self-willed.
Not self-willed.
Not soon angry.
You can't be quick-tempered.
Mm-hmm.
No. If you get reprimanded because you made a mess up in the pulpit, take it. If you can't take it, then get out the pulpit.
That's right.
You got up there and said something you ain't got no business saying.
Mm-hmm.
If you said it open, then we're going to get you open.
Yeah.
I ain't going to take you in no office. You didn't say it in the office.
Right.
No, we're going to deal with it open, and you're going to correct it open, or you're going to be fired open.
Amen.
Eh?
Amen.
What did he say?
Not soon angry.
Can't get mad quick. I don't care if the word, amen, beat you so hard, you start going backward in age. I mean, just keep getting hit. 50, 49, 48, 30, 36, 20, 5, 1. Beat you all the way back to childhood. You got
to
take it.
Back to a baby.
This the qualifications here.
Not soon angry.
I want this to be good. If I got any men that are visiting, you claim you was an elder. I know many of you got ordained in your organization. They catechized you out of a book, or you took an exam. That don't work here.
No.
That's not God's order.
No.
What he's reading is God's order.
That's right.
Come on, son.
Not soon angry.
Can't get mad quick.
Not given to wine.
What?
Not given to wine.
Why are you drinking a toast to your wife?
Not given to wine.
Why are you drinking a toast to your wife?
Go ahead, man. Go ahead.
Why are you doing drinking dinner wine?
Drinking dinner wine.
Well, the Bible says drink no longer water, but use a little wine for thy stomach's sake. Use a little.
Use a little.
Use is in two forms.
Mm-hmm.
Use is internally and externally.
That's right.
Externally, you'll find that when the man fell among thieves and the good Samaritan came by and bind up his wound and poured in oil and wine. Because of the alcohol and the strength of the wine, it will kill the germs of the wound.
That's right.
It was a cleanser.
That's right.
Sterilizer.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
Not given to wine.
And some of you are alcoholics and you are preaching.
Yeah.
You sweat so much from preaching, you smell like a whole brewery.
Amen.
Do you hear? Do you hear?
Not given to wine.
What else?
No striker.
Uh-oh. The moment the word of God is preached, something gets so upset, they're ready to throw their hands up at you.
Yeah.
Someone say, oh, well, we see you doing this, but I ain't hitting nobody.
I
ain't hitting nobody.
That's right.
I'm doing this to show you what I'm going to do to you with the book. Old Testament, New Testament. And we use both of them.
Both of them.
Work on you with the book.
That's right.
Yeah?
Amen.
The word of God hits you, and when it's time for you to speak, brother, and only for you to get up and throw off on the message,
no.
You might as well take it.
Amen. No striker.
Can't be a striker.
Mm-hmm.
What else?
Not given to filthy lucre.
You ain't got no business loving money.
Amen.
A person shouldn't have to pay you every time you do something.
Mm-hmm.
You put a doorbell up, $20. Fix a lock, $50. Help them up the step, $2 a step.
Mm-hmm.
Love money.
Love money.
You can't just help somebody?
Amen.
You mean we that bad, we just can't help a person?
Amen.
Without looking for anything in return?
Amen.
That's the way some folks are not like that. These false prophets that charge you even for counsel.
Yes, they will.
I'll counsel you free. I'm going to point you right to the book.
That's right.
Now, the way it is now, these preachers will charge you up front.
Up front.
Before they speak for you.
Oh, yeah.
I want to say to all viewers, you should not be paying T.D. Jakes. You should not be paying Creflo Dollar. You should not be paying Fred Price. You should not be paying none of these fellas. Just to preach.
Just to preach.
The word of God is free.
That's right.
There's a man now, Baptist preacher, Columbia, South Carolina, asked me to come preach for him. He said, would you do it? I said, yes, as soon as I get some time. He said, how much do you charge? I looked. Who is it that pays to die?
That's right.
Nobody called a person. Will you kill me? Yeah. How much you call? $2,000.
Amen.
I come to your church and wire it up with the scripture. Thank God and level your entire church right down. I smash it down.
That's right.
With the Bible. And you ain't got to give me nothing.
Freely.
Thank God. We got a whole demolition crew.
That's right.
Huh?
That's right.
Read quick, son.
Not given to filthy lucre.
Not given to filthy lucre. Don't love money.
Mm-hmm.
What else?
But a lover of hospitality.
Yeah, know how to show hospitality. Know how to treat people.
That's right.
Amen. Know how to treat people.
Right.
I had one brother. He left and started some church. He said, Pastor Jennings didn't have enough love. He got tired of me reprimanding him. The men don't want to be reprimanded, but they love to reprimand others.
Right.
A love of hospitality. You know, some folks say you are loving when you allow them to do what they want to do.
Right.
You know the way a child feel when their father wear their behind out? I felt that way when I felt my father didn't love me. And when I was young, I felt my father didn't love me and didn't care. The only time I felt that way was when I was getting my behind whipped.
Right.
When everything was nice and dandy, I ain't feel that way.
Right.
I wasn't looking at what caused him to whip me.
That's right.
And that's the way we are. We don't look at what caused us to get reprimanded.
Yeah.
All right.
But a lover of hospitality.
What?
A lover of good men.
A lover of gay men.
Good men. Amen.
No, gay men.
A lover of good men.
I love good men. Holy good men.
Men. Good men.
If you're a gay man, you're welcome. Yeah. You're welcome to come and sit among men.
Yeah.
But you're not allowed to privately try to lure someone or manipulate someone and convince them that your world is right.
That's right.
Because see, then I'm going to throw you out. Because I ain't going to tolerate that. Every lesbian and every homosexual in the world is welcome to come to the truth of God.
Yeah.
Repent of your sins. And be because you need this.
Need it.
You need what we're preaching.
Yeah.
So you can be changed.
That's right.
But not to come to coerce others. Because then I'm going to change your exit. Your exit going to be changed then.
That's right.
Because now you got a different agenda.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. No recruiting here.
No, no.
Huh?
No, no.
I said no recruiting.
Amen.
Am I right, I said?
Yeah. That's right.
No recruiting.
That's right.
Amen.
Amen.
Don't be sneaking off to some gay parade and little boys want to take pictures of your anatomy and show it to some other little dirty boy.
Yep.
And then get mad when somebody call you a faggot.
That's right.
That's like someone holding a Confederate flag and get mad when someone call them a bigot. Then put the sign down.
That's right.
You're not a hoe. Take the ankle chain off.
Amen. Go ahead, go ahead.
You're not gay, brother, you ain't gay. Come out your skin tight pants. Am I right, Isaiah?
Oh, yeah.
Stop trying to dye your hair different colors. Stop trying to arch your eyebrows. What's the matter with you?
That's right.
That's right.
Ain't nothing wrong with putting Vaseline on your lips, but your lips shouldn't be so shiny. It reflects light. Couldn't be like armor all on my tire.
No. Go ahead.
Lord, thank God, I'll die preaching this.
That's right.
What he said?
A lover of good men.
I love good men.
Good
men. Men that are honest, humble,
yeah,
hardworking. Yeah. Men that are supportive.
That's right.
That love the truth of God. I don't mean men just stand out there and yell amen. I mean men that back this message up. Somebody told me of a one fella. He don't hardly have nobody. And he said, Pastor Jennings just got a bunch of yes men. I want all the men to be yes men for God.
Yeah.
We say, I say yes. Lord, yes. To your will and to your way.
That's it.
We want to say yes to everything God said.
That's right.
That bothers preachers when they see all these men.
Yeah,
that bothers them.
Yeah.
They ought to be thank God to have men in God's house. This is not even an eighth of the men that's with the truth of God.
No.
This is not even an eighth of them.
No.
This is not even an eighth of the women.
That's right.
Not even an eighth.
That's
I have
right.
to say like Queen Sheba, half has not been told. And we give God glory for it.
Amen.
Man, that's a real man. Don't mind following a real man. A man that's a weak man will follow anything weak and feeble.
That's right.
Because he ain't got no backbone.
That's right.
What is it?
A lover of good men.
What else?
Sober.
Sober, stable-minded.
Mm-hmm.
You're not unstable.
Yeah.
When a man that's unstable, oh, he's wishy-washy. You can't trust him. Huh?
Amen.
All right.
Just.
Honest. If you stole the church money and I asked you, Brother Williams, we're missing $2,500. Mm-hmm. Did you steal it? Yeah, Pastor Jennings, I stole it. Well, thank you for your honesty. You're fired.
That's right.
I respect your honesty.
That's right.
You're a thief, but you're honest.
An honest thief.
You're just an honest thief, that's all. Come on, son.
Holy.
What?
Holy.
Methodist.
Holy.
Pentecostal.
Holy.
Apostolic.
Holy.
Apostolic.
Holy.
Non-denominational.
Holy.
Lutheran.
Holy.
Mormon.
Holy.
Everything else might as well just sit down.
That's right.
You ain't got no business being all day and you ain't got the Holy Ghost.
No Holy Ghost. No way.
I mean, you got to have the real speaking in tongue.
Amen.
The real tongue.
Amen.
As the Spirit give utterance.
That's right. That's right. Amen.
Come on.
Holy.
Uh-huh.
Temperate.
Self-control.
Mm-hmm.
You got to have self-control when you're at the table.
That's right.
Again, always practicing getting all what you can get.
Yeah.
You got to learn how to suffer the want of things. Because
yeah.
The time may come, you may not can't get what you want.
Mm-hmm.
But being that you was temperate and have self-control, you won't sin to get what you want.
That's right.
Temperate.
Temperate.
Amen. He that strive for the match is temperate in how much?
All things.
How much?
All things.
That includes your wife.
That's right. Temperate in all things.
Can't always practice wrestling. Oh, you don't make sense now. Yes, I do. Yes, certainly I do. I'm preaching temperance.
That's right.
Suppose something happened and she can't lay with you. Suppose something happens, she can't lay with you. Suppose she's ill. What are you going to do, force her? Or are you going to be one of those dumb men and quote the scripture, well, I got power over a body. Does that mean force entry?
No.
You're so foolish, so silly. Did you hear what the Bible says there?
Temperate.
He that strive for mastery is temperate in everything.
In all things.
You shouldn't be get even if a go to a open buffet restaurant. Eat all you can eat.
Mm-hmm.
Still got to have temper.
Still temperate.
You don't sit there for about 4 hours, eat, sit back, go to sleep. Wake up, eat some more. take a nap again.
No.
Restaurant just keep looking at you. They wondering when you're getting out of here. This is doctrine. This is doctrine.
Temperate.
Amen.
I've been talking about being temperate in everything.
All things.
What is that?
But holding fast the faithful word, as he hath been taught.
How did this bishop get it?
As he hath been taught.
How did this elder get it?
As he hath been taught.
He was taught by an apostle.
That's right.
You got to have an apostle to teach these fellas.
That's what they
when
need.
You teach them right and they get it in you, you will know that you ain't got no business divorcing and remarrying and jumping up in pulpits, not ordained and seeing astronauts to make you preachers.
That's right.
Having all these vegans with little shiny men with silver helmets telling you to go preach. No, that's cartoonism.
Amen.
Come on, son.
Holding fast the faithful word as he has
been taught.
You see,
this part of the apostles' doctrine they don't like.
No.
Because this sets order.
That's right.
This cleans out pulpits around the world.
Yes, it will.
What it said?
Holding fast the faithful word as he hath been taught.
What?
That he may be able by sound doctrine.
What kind of teaching?
Sound doctrine.
Ain't nothing sound about remarriage and divorce.
No.
Ain't nothing sound about denouncing speaking in tongue.
No.
It ain't nothing sound about having more than one God.
Amen.
It ain't nothing sound about your wife being the first lady in your church. That ain't sound. That's sound. Junk.
That's right. That's right.
Ain't nothing sound about that.
No.
Oh, I can't even count the lot of letters I get from fellas. Pastor Jennings, I know God got something for me to do, but I don't know what it is. And sit and listen and be taught.
Amen.
There's some teaching in you.
That's what you need.
Ain't no need for no one to go jump behind a car and drive, and you don't know how.
That's right.
If you can't tell the gas from the brake, I'm not trusting you.
Don't trust him.
Because when someone say stop, you're going to press the accelerator.
Yes, you will.
And someone say go, you're going to press the brake and you're going to kill everybody,
yeah.
Including yourself.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
That he may be able by sound doctrine.
To do what?
Both to exhort and to convince the gainsayers.
You got a job in front of you.
Job.
All right.
For there are many unruly and vain talkers and deceivers. Especially they of the circumcision.
Well, you mean they're the circumcision?
Mm-hmm.
Them that thought their heart was circumcised.
Yeah.
Them that claim they're born again.
Right.
Claim they're saved.
Mm-hmm.
But the Bible says stop their mouths.
Whose mouths must be
shut
stopped.
Shut them up.
Must be.
Because what do they do with their mouth, son?
Who subvert whole houses.
They go around subverting the whole housing. How do they do it?
Teaching things which they ought not.
Why do they do it?
For filthy lucre's sake. Amen. Money.
No brother should be anxious for a title.
No way.
Even brothers that's not in the pulpit.
That's right.
If somebody come in and don't know you and don't know you're not a minister and just happen to address you, elder so-and-so or bishop so-and-so, and you know you're not a minister, you don't eat it up.
No.
Correct them. Oh, no, I'm not a minister. I'm not a minister. I'm just brother. Be honest.
Be honest.
Because if you let them throw that on you and you keep going on, you know you're dishonest.
That's right. That's right.
Is that right?
Amen.
I was in England and Huey was with me. And Nassau, Bahamas. And Huey. Where are you? Come here, Huey. Come on out from back there, adjusting your camera. Now, come out here a minute. Anybody would think he's a bishop. Anybody. I mean, look at him. And someone said, well, his height ain't got nothing to do with it. Give me the book of Samuel.
Mm-hmm.
In the book of Samuel, God told the prophet that I'm going to have a prophet over Israel.
Right.
Well, the prophet went to David's father's house,
mm-hmm.
which was Jesse.
Right.
Now let's read fast.
1 Samuel chapter 16, and we're at verse 6.
This is an excellent example.
Mm-hmm. And it came to pass.
Read quick.
And it came to pass when they were come that he looked on Eliab, and said, surely the Lord's anointed is before him.
Oh, he looked right on the first fella he saw. Sure that.
The Lord's anointed is before
him. When I was in Nassau, Bahamas, they asked Rick, I got through preaching, you know. I was done preaching, and so the minister there, you know, met Huey for the first time. So one of the younger ministers who didn't know Huey, he said, we're going to ask Pastor Ricky.
Pastor Ricky.
Pastor Johnson.
That's right.
To close us out in prayer. He said, I looked at Rick. Rick said, oh, I'm brother Johnson. Someone throw a title on you, brother. Be honest enough.
Yeah.
If you're not a professor, don't let no one call you a professor.
That's right. That's right.
In the days of Samuel, the mistake was made looking at the size of the men.
But the Lord said unto Samuel, look not on his countenance.
Don't look on his countenance.
Or on the height. Of his stature. Because so, I have refused him.
I did what?
I have refused him.
I refuse him. You can go away now. When I came up in falsehood, the false prophet I was under, you know what he taught us? He said that all brothers, you got to have a certain shaped head to be a preacher. He went over to Williams. He said to Williams, now you know you ain't no preacher. But people believe that kind of foolishness.
That's right.
It's not in how big or how small your head is. I don't care if your head is smaller than the tip of this microphone. And your feet was a size 22.
My Lord.
And your arms was as long as an elephant's trunk. And your neck was as wide as a neck brace. With the head the size of a microphone. In that strange condition, God, if he choose, can still make you a preacher. You will be an unusual specimen, but God can make you a preacher. Finish up so I can knock off. Everybody all right?
Yeah.
Come on, son.
For there are many unruly and vain talkers and deceivers, especially they of the circumcision,
who mouth
must be stopped,
who subvert hold houses,
teaching things which they ought not, for filthy lucre's sake.
Now that's the problem, ladies and gentlemen. The preachers are out preaching for money. So when any preacher tell you don't have to be ordained, turn your back, don't even pay it no mind, because it's plainly in the scriptures.
Ordain elders.
You got to be ordained. Any man say he's an elder, he became one by not being ordained, Satan even reached to him. Satan reached and ordained him.
That's right.
And sent him out.
That's right.
You got to be ordained by an apostle to have the thing right. Mm-hmm. Repent of your sins. You that are watching. I think of when I was in Bahamas, there was a brother who was watching the telecast on internet. And when I said, do anybody want to be baptized in the name of Jesus Christ? He was way in the Bahama Islands. When I said, stand up, he stood up in his living room. Huh? In the living room, way in the Bahamas. He stood up. He was ready. And he went down in water in the name of Jesus Christ. Thank God. Now what he done, everybody got to do.
That's right.
Anybody here want to be baptized in the name of Jesus Christ and get your sins washed away? Stand on your feet. Wonderful.